Okay guys, it's Lance Bowen again, as promised. I know it's quite late in the evening, this is actually 7:22 at the moment. My morning started at 4:15 a.m. this morning, so it's been kind of a long day. But I did mention yesterday that I was going to do a rope routine by the maestro himself of the ropes, Mr. Francis Tabary. And it goes something like this. I have adjusted it a little bit just to suit my performance needs. Hopefully I'll get this sent off to him at some point, probably tomorrow now. And hopefully get some feedback from him and see what he thinks. And if there's any improvements, he's the guy to let me know. So it starts like this with two lengths of ropes. Now all you have to do, guys, is simply add one to the other and then you tie the knot in the centre of the two ropes, something like this. And trust me, guys, that really is a knot. I wouldn't lie to you. Now, sometimes, just sometimes, guys, even the ordinary things in life, like the ordinary garden variety knot, is sometimes capable of doing the extraordinary, as he simply jumps from the centre here and lands all the way down there. Now I can put this back for you guys, but I'll do it so slowly you will see the exact moment it happens. And by the way guys, I never lie. Watch. It happened then. Did you see it? Like I said, I never lie. That really is the moment he actually comes back. Even stranger than that is if you tap your hands here, he actually jumps over there. Stranger than that again, guys, believe it or not, because this routine gets even stranger as we go along. If you actually untie the rope at this point, something truly, truly remarkable happens, because now you end up with a very, very little length of rope, and of course, a very, very long one. Now, to fix this, I want you to watch the little length of rope very, very carefully. All you do is you simply add it to the long rope and you hang him on the centre, something like that. If you go 1, 2, and 3, I guarantee you will see the exact moment he melts back into 1 and 1, something like that. Now, if I wanted to, I could actually push the envelope even further by taking two ends here and having two ends there. But if I pull, he will actually stretch and stretch and stretch. He'll keep on stretching, of course, until we end up with 3 of them. People think I cheat. It really is a terrible life I lead, but that really is 1. This one here has to be number 2. And of course, this last one here is number 3. Now, I know what you're thinking, guys. Yeah, 3 ropes, 2 eyes, and we've had a few to drink. It's too much to watch, so I'll actually get rid of one for just a moment and we could work with just the 2 ropes. I hope you can see this on camera, that there really is 1, 2, 3, and 4 ends, and there really is 1 and 2 middles. So if we have 2 middles and we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 ends, if I wish to go back to 1, I simply blow. I feed the pieces through the fingers and I allow it to drop, and that then allows me to have just the 1 length of rope, something like that. I know what you're thinking, the ends really are causing a little bit of trouble, so what I'll do is if I take the ends just here, I can actually pop them off and I'll keep them just under my arm. I'll work with the centre of the rope. But believe it or not guys, there's absolutely nothing I can do with the centre. I really do need ends. So if I was to take the ends back from under my arm, watch the moment that they actually touch the rope, they simply add themselves back on, something like this. Now, I know they seem to be causing a little bit of a problem, so what I'm going to do guys, is I'm going to tie these 2 ends and I'm going to tie them in a nice tight knot, something like that. I hope you can see that. Now, most people would have forgotten by this point about this piece here around the neck, but not you guys. You're smarter than that. Now, watch very carefully, because all I'm going to do with this length of rope is simply hang him through the loop. If you hang him through the loop, something like that, something truly remarkable happens, because this length of rope here, if I was to wiggle, he would stretch and stretch and stretch, and he will keep on stretching until he goes down, travels over the knot, and I believe we end up back where we began, which was with 2 lengths of rope held together in the centre with a knot. The strange thing is guys, that knot actually comes off, which is kind of weird. Yeah, I haven't got any spectators with me at the moment, so I'm gonna have to untie it myself. So if I was to collect the ends, something like this, take the knot out of my mouth so you can actually hear me speaking properly, take this end and simply feed it straight through the centre. I hope you can see that there, straight through the centre of the loop. If I was to pull, something truly remarkable happens, because what it does is it actually creates lots of different size ropes. Not one seems to be the same, which causes just a minor problem, guys. Of course, not for you. The problem's all mine. So I'm going to try and fix this for you, because now, believe it or not, guys, I actually have a length of rope which is approximately up to my chest. We have another rope here, which is, give or take, the same length as my forearm. And of course, the one around the neck, this, and it's a family show, guys, so I'm going to say it's the same length as my leg. Now, my job as a magician is very, very simple. It's to ensure that the long length, the medium length, and of course, the short length, all look the same. To do it, it's very, very simple, guys. You use magic. You blow here, you pull, and they actually stretch and become one. They become two and three lengths of rope, all the same again. Now, to finish, guys, I usually finish with a small finale. I'd usually hand this to one spectator. I haven't got one, so I'm going to have to hold it myself. I would take another one here and hand that to another spectator. They would be holding those, which I'd then take one of these ropes. And I always say to them, I guarantee you, I will take you back in time, just one step back in time, to just probably 30 seconds ago. And then when I snap my fingers, I guarantee you one thing and one thing only, I will end up with a little rope. And that, guys, is the master himself, Francis Tabary's routine. Of course, I've altered a little bit. Please feel free to comment. I'll send this off to him and see what he thinks. And let's see if any parts need to be jiggled about a bit, or see if he's happy with it. But thanks very much for watching, guys. And I believe I'd like to call that the ultimate professor's nightmare. Thanks very much for watching, guys. I hope you all enjoy. Please feel free to comment. All comments are welcome, good or bad. Thanks very much. Bye-bye now.